Hello, I'm Zion Lanier.
Hi, I'm Destiny DeCoupe.
Hi, I'm Carl Berg.
And I'm Claude Moore.
And welcome to BT Live.
So guys, how you guys doing on this beautiful day?
Great, great, great.
Good, how are you?
You know, I'm good. So what's your plan for spring break?
My plans are probably sleep, probably play some video games, probably get out, go to the beach. You know, I'll let you, Destiny.
Cool. Probably hang out with friends and family, you know.
Sounds nice.
Fun. You know, I'll go. You know, just go to the beach with friends and family, just enjoy the sun.
Well, that sounds fun.
The beach. Maybe I'll see you there. I also plan on going to the beach this spring break.
Nice.
I love playing beach football. Maybe we could play a little game down there.
Yeah,
oh,
nice.
I heard you guys interviewed the football players, right?
Yeah, we did.
How about we take a look at that?
Johnson, and I'm going to New Mexico Highlands University.
Teron Ware, going to Assumption College.
Carl Berry Jr., Shaw University.
Okay, so first question is, what are you guys majoring in?
I plan on majoring in sports management when I get into, you know, New Mexico, and normally take that into the business field.
Okay.
I'm going to major in kinesiology. I'm trying to get into the athletic training field and all that.
I'm a major in communications. I'm can pursue a career in that after college. That's the plan if football does not work out.
Okay, that's nice.
I said, what made you want to take football to the next level in college?
Basically, you know, since being a kid, everyone thinks of and dreams of taking their sport and everything they do to the next level. So it was always just, I'm playing at this level now, so what I got to do to get better to get to this level? And then it just keeps going on. And so right now, the next step in the path is going on and playing in college.
My freshman year, my coach Strong, he saw something in me that I didn't see yet. He kind of worked with me, and then my junior year, everything kind of came out.
Growing up, I got introduced to my position late. Growing up, I realized they could give me a free education, and my parents don't have to pay for college. So I figured, keep working on this, doing what I love, and I would get that free education.
How has football shaped you into who you are today?
Basically, it shapes us into young men and helps us just gain a sense of responsibility and confidence in ourselves. Because a lot of kids at this age normally have confidence issues or responsibility issues, and it helps just shape you into a better person.
I usually say it put that demon in me, like, you know, the pups turn into dogs. You know, it kind of makes me mature a lot.
It made me into the hard worker that I am today. I just like the grind and the feeling of progressing.
So, like, I know you guys are in college, like, about to go to college. So, like, after college, what are you planning to do?
Hopefully, if football can continue, then, you know, I'm just going to take that as far as it goes. That's normally a goal that normally every kid has. But if that doesn't work, then something in the business field, I can fall back on that sports management degree that I'm planning on getting.
If it doesn't work out, I'm going to come back to the town, you know, help out the community, probably coach the DBs a lot, and, you feel me, help the young people stay on track.
If the NFL does not work out for me, I plan on playing Canadian football or overseas or in the newest AFL league that came out. But if that doesn't work out, I'm going to pursue a communications career with a degree. I'm going to get in that and come back and coach.
Interesting.
Okay. What was your favorite memory while playing football?
I would say my favorite memory was probably, it would be either out of my sophomore year, you know, my first year starting, first game of the year, my first catch, I took it down for a touchdown. So it was the first time for everything, first game, first catch, first score. And it's a tie between the entire senior year, having all my guys come back and just playing together as a family again.
My junior year against Shawnee going in the fourth quarter. I was guarding a four-star recruit. He was committed to NC State. Came up, he caught a pass, came up, smacked him. We exchanged some words, and then it was ball game from there. He didn't catch another ball from there.
Pretty much, I had to cram everything into one season, which is no problem. I like that pressure, and I took it very well by myself. But my favorite moment would have to be beating Highland or Delsey, that feeling in the locker room of getting that big win, it was a good feeling for me and my guys.
All right, so my last question is, so to the younger athletes going to college, what advice would you give them?
I would say just to make sure you guys stay on your grades, because I know a lot of people here, they struggle with school or they're just not on top of the things because they don't feel like it. But that's one of the main things that you have to stay on, because for young athletes, that's like the biggest thing a coach looks at for them, like anything else. You could be as good of an athlete as you can, but the minute your grades drop, the coach is just going to just cut everything off.
And piggybacking off what he said, you know, the grind is free. I mean, the dream is free. The grind is sold separately.
Hey, basically, to all you younger guys, you can't let nobody tell you what you can do, because a lot of people tell me there was no way I was playing college ball with one season of football, and I ended up doing it, ended up getting a ranking in the state, and there's nothing you can do. Make sure you stay on top of your grades, too. That's very important. Not a lot of colleges tell me no because my grades, but make sure you stay on top of your grades for anything.
Carlton, I didn't know you was in that segment. Can you tell us a little about how that went?
Yeah, the segment was great. I really liked the questions that were asked of me. It was a great interview overall.
That's good. That's good. So what college are you going to commit to?
I'm attending Shaw U in Raleigh on July 5th. I'll be enrolling, and I just plan to do great things there.
And, wow.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah, I got one more question. And you said, what are you going to college for again? I'm sorry, it just slipped my mind.
I'm going to college to play football, and I'm majoring in communications.
So I know you do communications, and then you had your own little interview here with the basketball team. So let's see how that went.
My name's Manny. John Paul.
Wesley.
Coach Derek.
And for Coach, I would like to know, how was it coaching the team throughout the season?
Yeah, we had a good year this year. It was quite a ride we went on throughout the playoffs. Definitely a season of peaks and valleys. You know, at times we were playing very well, at times we were not playing very well. But these three, and especially our seniors that graduated or are going to graduate, we had a great year. And very proud of them. And you know, although we had a great year this year, very much looking forward to next year, what next year should bring.
What are your hobbies outside of playing basketball? What do you like to do?
I really don't have no other hobbies, because like, I just want to be that great at basketball. So my really main hobby is either I'm lifting or I'm practicing or working on my skill for basketball.
I would probably be like playing football or like just working out.
What motivates you guys to keep playing basketball?
To be able to go to college and get a free education.
Yeah, having a free education is huge. So that's one thing I play for, because I don't want my parents to want to have to worry about like how much they have to pay for my college. And also like getting to the league is one thing. So like whatever way I could get there the quickest and the fastest. My parents also motivate me because they work double hours and stuff. So I just want to make sure they don't have to work anymore. And also like my family members and siblings, I just want them to be proud of something, knowing that like I'm not just out here doing anything.
Free education, and like when I grow up, I want to do something, get paid for something that I enjoy doing, and I enjoy doing basketball. So,
all right, who do y'all feel like y'all model? What NBA player do you feel like you model your game after?
I would say Russell Westbrook, because like I'm like really aggressive, and like when I start getting hype and stuff, and like these two start dunking, like that just motivates me. And then like if I get an and-one, like I start screaming even more. And then like I'm like hyped up on defense, and I'm getting everybody hype. And if you watch Russell Westbrook play, like all he is just energy throughout the whole game. So that's what I try to bring to the team, and I'm more of an energy person. Like I try to bring that energy and that defensive energy. So I would say Russell Westbrook.
All right, Joel Embiid, because he's like, he's a factor in all parts of the game, inside, outside, defensively, all around. And he talks a little bit of trash, too. So,
I'd probably say, like, Kevin Durant, because, like, he's just he can dribble, and he's long. So, like, yeah.
Playoff game, I know it's probably frustrating to play. So how did you all feel when you lost, even though you probably should have won?
Yeah, that loss, it stings, especially when you don't get to practice the next day, you know what I mean? And it wasn't from a lack of effort, just left some plays out there, but it shows, you know, as a coaching staff and these guys, that nobody's invincible. in the playoffs. You know, anybody can lose at any time. And failure can teach you a lot. So you learn from it and you grow and hopefully get another chance at it next year.
Right. I noticed all of you had a great season this year. I'm very proud of what you boys did. So I just want to know is, what's the plans for the future?
Make it back to sectionals and win, and then go on to Rutgers.
Like you said, go to Rutgers. Also, I really didn't know, all three of us were going to get first team, so, I would make that a goal again to get first team again, because it was, pretty cool seeing your name up there, knowing that your hard work paid off.
Basically, trying to make it to Rutgers, basically.
What? Okay, so what is your favorite memory while playing basketball?
I could say getting my first dunk last year.
Highland.
Pretty cool, yeah.
Mine would be these two dunking, Manny and Wesley, because if you guys watch the games, every time they dunk, I start screaming. So I get hyped up when they start doing their thing. So that just helps me play better. So I would say my favorite part of this season is just them dunking the ball every time, because I'd see it on TV, but I'm only beat her when it happens. So now having these two athletic guys with me, it's just fun to watch.
Opening night at Northern?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mine would probably be Somerville, because he came back.
That was crazy, yeah.
I have a couple. I don't know, their sophomore year up at Bordentown was a fun day. For me, probably my favorite game this year would have to be probably at Neptune or at Mattawan. Mattawan played very well, probably the best we played all year. And Neptune, the environment, the way that game went in the first half, how we played in the second half, I'd say that's probably, and even though we didn't win that wall game, it was a great learning experience to be up there and to see that atmosphere and that environment. You know, the whole playoff journey in the season was fun. So I'd have to say Mattawan, though, if I had to choose one game, guys.
Whoa, what are you guys doing?
Wrestling?
Well, since you guys are wrestling, let's go to the wrestling segment.
I'm Mike LeMond.
I'm Jake Marshall.
Craig Cook.
And I'm Coach Litney.
Okay, so today the first thing I would like to know is for Coach, how is it like coaching them this season?
It was a lot of fun to have all three of these guys as a really solid group of seniors that all of them were in the district finals at the end of the year. Two of these guys, Mike and Craig, both wrestling in college and made it to the state tournament. Jake improved greatly, so it was a lot of fun knowing that at any time in the season, you could rely on these three guys to get the job done and win, no matter what team we were going against.
So I know that you guys did really good this year, but if I had to ask a question, what would be your toughest opponent this year?
Yeah, so I made it to the state tournament, and I was undefeated going in. My first loss was actually to the kid that took second in the state, so that was probably my toughest opponent all year.
My toughest opponent would probably be the kid I wrestled at district finals.
My toughest opponent would probably be the region semifinals. It was the reigning state champ, Rob Kennard.
What are your guys' future plans?
I'm wrestling in college at Davidson Elkins. It's a D2. It's actually going to be the first year of the program, so I'm really excited to go.
I signed my papers for the United States Marine Corps.
I'm planning on walking on and wrestling at Ryder.
All right, so I know all you guys had good memories there, but if you guys, all four of you had to pick your favorite memory, what would it be?
Favorite memory would probably be senior night this year. The fans were packed. It was a great match. We all won, so it was a pretty good night.
Yeah, my favorite memory would probably be senior night. It was a lot of fun.
Mine would probably be my 100th win at Lacey. My whole family came. The whole team was there supporting me. All my friends came and my girlfriend. So, I don't know, it was really memorable. It was cool.
I know you and Craig have over 100 wins. So how does it feel to have over 100 wins?
It feels great. All the hard work that I put in over the years finally paid off. Thankfully, didn't have any injuries throughout my career, so that played a big part too, just staying healthy, and it was fun. It feels good. Just all the work we put in, it has something to show for it, so I'm greatly appreciative for it.
And finally, my last question would be, since I know you're a coach and you three are wrestlers, what made you guys want to do that?
Yeah, pretty good. So I started involved in the sport when I was 6 years old. My uncle was a coach, and he used to take me to the matches with him, so that made me really interested. And then I started wrestling and wrestled from basically like first grade all the way up through high school. And then my brother was really involved with it. He wrestled in college at West Virginia and Rider. And then I started coaching as well at Absagami High School, which is in near Atlantic City in South Jersey, and then at Township, and just really liked the sport and just all the relationships you build with all the people you coach with and all the kids on the team and everything. And it's just been an honor to coach it for all these years and be involved in it.
Yeah, I didn't really start sport until like 6th, 7th grade. I played a bunch of other sports growing up, and when I was really young, I did Tiger Showmans, which is like grappling, kickboxing, like mixed martial arts. So when I was in 6th grade, my dad was like, hey, you want to try wrestling? I was like, sure. So after that, I just never looked back. And
I started wrestling my sophomore year in high school, and this guy right here actually got me to start.
I started wrestling when I was 6 years old because my mom put me in it because I sucked at every other sport.
Woo, well, that was fun.
Yeah, next time, Carl, I think I should slam you.
Yeah, all right, buddy, don't do that.
Hey, balance is never the answer.
That's right.
Yeah.
And thank you for joining BT Live.